Chapter 5, Other Units of Measurements and Household System. In concept number 1, we will go over the units of measurement such as international units, mille equivalents, percentages, and ratios. International units are measuring high alert medications and make sure that we'll measure the action and not the weight. Example 1. Insulin 30 units, heparin 50 units. Insulin, as you might know, is the medication for people with diabetes, and heparin, they are the blood thinners. Here is the example on the screen of the syringe, which is calibrated in exactly units. Write using Arabic numbers the followed by the space and word the units. Do not use commas unless at least 5 digits in the number. Example: 6 units, it's just 1 digit in the number, no commas obviously. 1000 units, 4 digits in the number, we don't use the comma yet. And 250,000 units, that's where we started to use comma, because we have already the more than 5 digits in this number. Caution: abbreviation U is now on joint commissions. Do not use list, since it can be misread as additional 0 if we are not writing that carefully. Second unit is mille equivalent. Mille equivalents, MEQ, are units representing the number of grams of medication in 1 milliliter of normal solution. They are used to measure electrolytes and ionic activity of medication in a variety of oral IV solutions. Example is the label on the right, potassium chloride, that has the dosage strength 20 mille equivalent per 50 milliliters. So this is the example of 20 mille equivalent as a unit. The third measurement is a percentage measurement. Remember that percentage means out of 100. So usually percentage measurements are used in intravenous solutions to express a dosage strength or concentration in the IV solutions. We need to memorize. Interpreting the percentages, we want to think of the number of grams of medication, the number of grams of medication per 100 milliliters of the solution. Examples: A, 5% solution contains 5 grams of medication in 100 of milliliters and can be written as a ratio 5 gram over 100 milliliters. The second example, B, 2.5% solution that contains 2.5 gram of medication in 100 milliliter and can be written as 2.5 gram to 100 milliliter ratio. Most common percentage dosages are also, we will encounter them, then we will go over IV dosages. One of the example is dextrose dosages. They usually written as the whole numbers. 5% dextrose in water gives the abbreviation D5W. We will read as 5 gram of medication, which is dextrose, in 100 milliliter of water. That gives us the ratio 5 gram over 100 milliliter. 2. Sodium chloride. Look at the label on the right. Sodium chloride with the concentration of 0.45 hundredths of the percent. Usually sodium chloride concentration is written as a decimal fraction, and this example gives us 0.45 hundredths percent. Please notice this is still percent, it's not percent converted to a decimal. We also can call it sometimes a half of normal saline. We will interpret it as a ratio 45 hundredths of the gram per 100 milliliter, or if we need conversions, that it will be 450 milligram per 100 milliliter. The last one is ratio measurements. Ratio, similarly to the percentages, they represent a little bit different ratio, not always out of 100. Ratio measures on the labels represent the dosage strength of the solution as a part of the medication per parts of the solution. Example of such ratio is 1 to 100, or maybe 1 to 1000, or maybe 1 to 10. The less solution a medication is dissolved in, the stronger the solution, which means we can say high concentration. Example 1. On the label on the right about the epinephrine injection, we see the ratio which corresponds to the dosage strength, 1 to 1,000. How do we need to interpret that? We will read it as 1 gram of medication in 1,000 of milliliters of the solution. However, we also can notice that there is in parenthesis another dosage strength using as a ratio. This is 1 milligram and over milliliter. How we can receive it? If we will write the initial ratio 1 gram over 1,000 milliliters, then we also can convert the gram by multiplying by 1,000 to 1,000 milligram per 1,000 milliliter. By reducing 3 zeros, we will receive 1 milligram over 1 milliliter, which is exactly stated in parentheses on the label. The second example illustrates that every ratio on the label has to be reduced to the lowest terms. So the ratio to 10 must be reduced to the lowest terms as 1 to 5 by division both sides of the previous ratio by 2. Concept number 2, household measurements. In household measurements, that usually we use spoons like teaspoon, cup, tablespoon, ounces, pint, quarts, all these household measurements we use also at home in the kitchen. So there are a couple of useful conversions between a household and metric system. Keep in mind that household system is pretty much approximate measurement, since you cannot measure exactly the correct amount of medication either using the spoons or maybe measuring cups. So therefore the conversions may vary. Some important of them are ounce, 1 ounce, usually 2 tablespoons, which is in the metric system is 30 milliliter, 1 tablespoon, 1 T capital or TBS, 15 milliliters, teaspoon, 1 T lowercases, and also it could be written as TSP, which is equivalent to 5 milliliters, measuring cup, 1 cup is 8 ounces, which in terms of the milliliters is 30 milliliters times 8 ounces, 240 milliliters. However, sometimes you can also see as 250 milliliters in other literature, pint. 1 pint is 16 ounces, which is about 500 milliliters, and 1 quart is 2 pints or 32 ounces, which is 1,000 milliliters or 1 liter. Please watch video examples in the weekly guide on how to convert units within household system and between household and metric systems.